I owe millions. Welcome back, DHS, to a special presentation of this week's newscast, presented by yours truly, G Money. I'm gonna give y'all some updates on the basketball standings. The girls right now are 9-1 in district with their wins last week over Paul Pewitt, 46-30, and their wins this week over Queen City, 63-42. The boys are looking good, 5-3 with their wins last week over Paul Pewitt, 54-41, and the win over Queen City, 51-45. Right now, I'm going to get into the interview with two of our Lady Bears varsity players. I'm here with CeCe Cheatham and Chrissy Williams of the Lady Bears. Got a couple questions for y'all. Before the game, how do y'all prepare to get ready to play?
Well, Coach always tell us to put your siblings right and just focus on what we need to do that night.
I mean, you know, you can listen to music, be over there by yourself, you know, just doing your own thing and come together as a team when you get in the locker room, you know, get pumped up for the game, you know, just be ourselves in there.
All right. So y'all was district champs last year. What's y'all plan on repeating?
Well, I mean, one thing we can do is just go out there, play, try to play great, hustle hard, be a team, communicate, and, you know, hustle hard, you know what I'm saying? Hustle, Rick Ross.
Do whatever it takes.
Yeah, I mean, get out there. I mean, yeah, everybody makes mistakes, turnover, double dribble, but you know.
That's okay.
Y'all need to stop by that, too.
I mean, but you can regain it, though. I mean, you can just come
back.
Okay, that's like saying y'all.
You catch that ball.
That's like saying you when you
next
shoot.
Next question.
Okay.
Yeah, all right. Y'all only lost this year was to New Boston. So, what y'all got for in the second round?
I mean, well, you already know. We was out there trying to do our thing. We was up by 20-something, as y'all recall the game. We can go back to the highlights and see.
Yeah.
But, I mean, and we missed us throwing the ball together. I guess we got it too pumped up in our heads. But, I mean, this second round going to be a pretty good match. You know, we're going to try to stay up and hustle hard and do our thing. Come out there and beat.
Y'all lost by 1 point that game.
Yeah, because, I mean, you know, me and Chris is at the bottom down there. Marquisha dropped in, and she, you know, she put the little pump fake on her, and I fouled her.
Okay.
She got the little 3 point throw, and then it was like 3.2 seconds in the game left. So, I mean, what else can we do besides just throw the ball? We tried to regain some points, but, you know, it didn't work out.
Yeah, I just get them these next. All right, last question for y'all. What's been the highlight of this season so far?
Well,
just being together as a team.
I mean, we never came together. We used to didn't even like each other. I mean, we didn't even know each other until, you know, basketball came up. And, you know, we started building friendship, and we became a family. I mean, if somebody gets hurt, we're there to pick them up. Somebody fall down or trip on a stump, we're there behind their back. I mean, it's just us. That's what we do. We're DeKalb Lady Bears.
Original.
Congratulations to the following students who placed at the Fort Worth Stock Show. In the Brahmin Show, Mackenzie Harvey got third in class, and Hannah Darby also competed. In the Beefmaster Show, Caitlin Darby got seventh in class, Caitlin Brand and Anna Allen also competed. In the Santa Gertrudis Show, Chandler Richardson got eighth in class. In the Simmental Show, Foster Fannin got fourth in class. In the Charlotte Show, Tristan Hill got seventh in class. And I would also like to congratulate the DeKalb FFA Cattle Show team who won Herdsman at Fort Worth. Just a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to come see the Bears and Lady Bears play LK tonight at 7 o'clock. That's all for this week. Be right back next week on a Friday. Swag.